Here on BBC Two now, on their new regular day and after their Christmas break, Leslie Judd and Fred Harris present Micro Live.
Welcome to the first MicroLive of 1987.
In tonight's programme, we'll be taking a look at Miami's new citywide communication system.
We'll be visiting a training course designed for people who are terrified of computers.
And we discover how even the simplest micro can get access to whole libraries of information. Oxford may be the city of dreaming spires, but even at England's oldest university, there's no escape. Once they were used only in science departments. Today, every field of study needs its computers, and more people are having to use them. It's easy to forget just how recent the micro-revolution is. Only a decade or so ago, most computers lived behind locked doors and were used only by highly trained specialist staff. Nowadays, it seems they're everywhere. Some people have taken to computers rather like the proverbial ducks to water, but there are still many who react with sheer and absolute terror. Like most universities, Oxford does teach people to use computers. The Computer Training Centre offers courses at every level, but the Tuesday afternoon class is unique.
Welcome to Computing for the Terrified. This is a special class for people who've never touched a computer before and are feeling a bit nervous about their first experience with technology. Before we discuss your questions...
The group of people who come here for the afternoon is very mixed. Some are undergraduates, others are dons. But the course is open to everyone who works at the university. What they do have in common is a very real fear of the unknown.
Now, everyone knows that if you hit the wrong key on a computer, something terrible will happen. So the first principle I want you to remember is this. The computer will not explode. I'd like each of you to find a computer in the room, and you have 5 minutes to make the computer explode by pressing the wrong keys.
At first, there's no attempt to do anything with the computer. It's enough just to get used to touching it. Now, are you terrified?
Absolutely, yes.
Why have you come?
Because I realise that even children in schools are using them, and I have no knowledge at all, and I feel I've just been left out, and I'm going to be illiterate about computers. My little girl is going to know about them, and I'm not.
So what are you hoping to get out of this afternoon?
To understand what all the words mean, and to actually have a sort of understanding about how to use a computer, a very basic understanding. I've never even played with one.
Well, one of the conditions on which my employers said they'd take me on is that I'll have some idea how to feel confident with a keyboard and to know how to work a computer on a basic level.
Have you ever used one before?
Well, I've used the ZX Spectrum for playing games on, but that's about as far as it goes.
So would you describe yourself as terrified?
I'm terrified of my ignorance more than of a computer.
I'd like to congratulate you on how close you came to exploding those computers. And I want to tell you the three stages of computing that you're going to go through in this class. And it's the three stages that everyone goes through who does any computing. Stage one is abject terror. This is when you've never touched a computer before and you don't know what to expect. Now, stage two is when you actually start using a computer. You try to do something on it, and you don't get exactly what you expect. Stage two is total confusion and frustration. Stage three is when something has gone right. You've tried to do something on a computer, and it's worked.
Kit Cowlishaw has come to Oxford from IBM to teach information technology. She had the idea for this course when she discovered that many people were unable to take even the first step towards computing.
Well, when I came here, my mission was to interest art students in computers. And I started by sending out a survey to find out what their current attitudes were and whether they were interested in taking computing classes. And I found that there was an enormous amount of interest. So when I interviewed the students and asked them why they hadn't taken the introductory course that exists already, they all said, oh, I couldn't do that. There would be other people in the class who'd already used computers, and I'd be terrified. And again, the word terrified seemed to pop up as the reason that held them back from going to the standard course. So I developed the idea for sort of a pre-introductory course for the terrified.
Each exercise allows the students to try a different aspect of computing, as painlessly as possible, and without the fear of failure. For example, by using an easily understandable guide to local restaurants, they discover that interrogating a database is not nearly as intimidating as it sounds. Well, we're about halfway through now. How are you feeling?
A lot better than at the beginning, certainly.
What do you think you've picked up?
I think I know where everything is on the keyboard now, and it all makes sense what's in the book. I'm learning to operate the keyboard to get something that comes up on the screen. So it's very pleasing.
Now, you were terrified at the beginning. How are you feeling now?
I'm enjoying it. I really am. I'm actually beginning to master a little bit here and there. But the program keeps escaping me every so often, but the textbook's good.
Fairly simple introduction, is it?
Yes, very good. Very
painless?
Straightforward. Yes. It is difficult, but on the other hand, I actually feel I could master the thing now.
Well, that's the nice thing about it, actually, that in one short afternoon, they get a glimpse of all these different things they can do with the computer. Normally, they would have had to sign up for 4-week or 8-week courses. Not everybody's willing to make that time commitment for something so unfamiliar. But in this time, what we can do, we can't train them, we can't make them experts, we can show them a taste of each type of computing, a little bit of databases, a little bit of word processing, a little bit of spreadsheets, some try programming. But they only do it for 20 minutes, little bites, little tastes. And then they know what they're aiming for, they know what's useful to them, they know what's interesting enough to them to justify signing up for that 8-week course that they weren't sure about before. That's the point.
Do they all go away happy?
Yes.
Every one of them?
Yes, every one.
Well, I think it's unbelievable that within 3 short hours you can go from one emotion to another, an emotion of near terror, apprehension, to one of fascination and excitement.
You know, you can go now. It's 5:00, end of class.
I want to finish my letter to my husband that they said I can do on the machine.
Okay, I'll leave you to it.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye.